Hello, Copic and the Craft Room fans. Michelle Houghton here. We are doing another fun ink technique this week with Yupo, so that mixed media paper. And I've got a sheet of acetate or just plastic, any type of plastic will do. And I have my Yupo, and I've got a group of markers and a colorless blender, as well as a water brush, which you're going to see a little later. So what I'm going to do first is I am going to lay all of these colors out on my acetate because I'm going to use this just like a paintbrush. So this is a paintbrush. That's my water brush that I am going to fill with colorless blender solution. And I am going to kind of dedicate that water brush to these alcohol techniques. I won't use it again with water. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start filling these colors, and I've marked a piece of paper underneath so I don't lose track of what I've done. So I've got a YR21 in that upper corner, and then I've got a YR24, I've got a YR18, R24, YR04, I've got an E35, and I've also got an E29. And the reason I wrote those down is because as stuff moves around, I'm not going to remember what I've got on there. And I'm just trying to keep track for myself what I'm reaching into. So I'm going to scoot that over just so you guys can see a little bit better what I'm doing. Now I could use a colorless blender, but I am going to pick up my ink with that brush that is filled with colorless blender. So I'm starting with that YR21, and what I realized right away is this color is so light, you just can barely even see it. So I'm probably gonna need to use darker colors, but I'm mapping out the shape of a pumpkin. Now I could start with a sketch, but any pencil lines I put on there and then go over with Copic ink will stay. The next is that YR24 that I'm trying, and this looks like I'm gonna be able to map it out. You know, you can see how this is picking this up off of that acetate. So I'm doing little bits at a time. As much as anything, I'm trying to map out the shape, and it's going to move around on that paper. It's quite liquidy. The colors lighten because I'm adding more alcohol solution to them with that brush. So that's part of it. As you lay things down, they will get lighter than what they start out as. And so you might end up using some darker colors that you wouldn't normally use. So you'll see kind of how that works. So coming in now with a YR04, picking up some of those darker oranges and starting at those top edges and kind of working my way down and then flicking from the bottom up. This is not going to look anything like our blended coloring. So I'm truly just painting the color on. They kind of lay on top of each other. They do some blending, but it's not going to blend like your cardstock. It just won't. It doesn't have that potential with this non-porous surface. I am going to come in with that R24, and I decide I'm not caring for that as much, so I switch over to the YR18 to get those deeper colors toward the base of the pumpkin. And I'm doing it in those sections that we kind of traditionally think pumpkins having. That's why I didn't start with a sketch this time. This is a shape that I know in my head. But if I wanted to, I could do super, super, super light pencil marks just to give myself even that outline to start with. But a pumpkin's always irregular. I just don't feel like I have to have it perfect because they always have such irregular shapes to them. And so I'm happy with that. I'm brushing off a little bit of color, going back to a light color, the YR24 to kind of fill out that other side, coming back in with YR04. Some of this, again, you guys see me do a lot of experimenting. This is experimenting with this technique and color. I'm going to grab some of that E35 and I'm adding a stem, but then I'm also adding some vine work. So I'm just picking a little bit up, coming over, adding those swirling vines. Look how light that E35 is now that I've picked it up with that water brush and colorless blender. It's considerably lighter. Now at any point I can stop and add more color onto my palette or my piece of plastic. To get more color going, because obviously eventually some of those colors I've picked up almost everything off of the plastic, and I might need to come back and add a little bit more. This is that E29, and now I'm going back in and defining some of those pieces. So going back over the stem of the pumpkin And now going back in and touching just some small pieces of the vine, trying to keep it a little bit smaller detail. I don't have to go down the full length of it, hitting just some spots so that we've got a little bit more definition. We can really see the vine a little bit better. But obviously here's an E29, which is almost black, and a lot of us get nervous when we pick it up out of our marker set, and it lightens up considerably because of that alcohol addition from the water brush. So adding those little swirls in, again, this is something I am comfortable freehanding, but it doesn't mean you are. You could also trace an image. Try using like the Express transfer paper and find an image you love and transfer it onto a paper. Just give yourself those general outlines so that you can come back and do some watercolor. Remember, this is watercolor. It should be loose and free. It does not have those details that sometimes we get, this super fine details with colored pencil or Copic marker work. This is truly more of a painting loose watercolor technique. Now I can go back and blend some of those colors together just lightly. I added some of that E29 into the creases of the pumpkin to darken it. And you can go back and forth and blend those together. I'm zooming in so you can get a little bit better feel of that, coming back in and adding some color onto there. What I realized also is that I needed one more color, because I decided there was so much open space that I really wanted to add some leaves onto the vine. So I do add a little bit of green onto my plastic, just so that I have something to pick up to do the leaves with. And unfortunately, I did not write down what I am using. I am guessing it's either, it looks like a YG63, just from looking at the cap over there on the side. So I'm going to say it's a YG63. So picking up that color on my water brush and adding these little tiny leaves. Obviously, you can see it's extremely light. But I can go back, hit them a second time. I can even go and get a whole different color and make those darker. I am not going to turn this one into a card right now so you guys can see. If I have a chance, I will pull one together later. But I really just wanted to share the technique. This is something totally different you can do with your Copic markers. And if you even have a few Copic markers and a colorless blender marker, you can do this. Now, the beauty of this is I could come in with my colorless blender and lift some of that ink off the Yupo paper. So see, coming back in, this time it's probably a G17, picking that up with my colorless blender this time and adding that onto those leaves. Now the trick with the colorless blender is it is picking that ink up on the nib. And so before I finish and recap that marker, what I have to do is make sure I get all of the ink off that nib. So I'm definitely going to make sure to scrub it off really well, make sure triple check that the nib is clean. The reason for that is if I cap it and let it sit off to the side, it will pull the ink back up into the body. So I will have kind of contaminated my colorless blender. As long as I pull it off, I am good to go. Thanks for stopping by today. Have a happy, colorful day.